In the previous video, I showed you a dumb design decision of a Guild Wars 2 trading bot author who decided it was a good idea to leak the API keys from all the bot users. These API keys can be used with the Guild Wars 2 API to get all the character information. I have written a small script that has collected data on all active bot users along with their wealth for the past 3 months. And so I want to have a look at this data and also talk about the threat model of botting in MMORPGs. Before we get into the data, let's talk about botting itself. I try to approach this topic as if I would design an MMORPG, and I'm well aware of the threat that somebody could hack the client or automate and bot certain aspects of the game. For me, MMORPGs have two major concerns they need to control in order to have a healthy game. One is the player satisfaction. This is purely subjective. It's about the feeling the players have that are often completely separate from reality. And the other one is keeping inflation of the in-game currency under control. If you ever played a game with rapid inflation, it is basically unplayable as a new player and it's just a terrible experience. And there are many game design decisions that you can make that affect these things. For example, a very typical thing games do is to have a gold sink. That means there are very expensive luxury items that just pull out masses of currency or items to fight against inflation. Items can become character bound, so they are removed from the economy, and much more. So what does this have to do with botting? So when most people imagine botting in an MMORPG game, they imagine bots that run around, kill monsters to level or collect items and gold. And so why is this bad for a game? First, with each kill, gold or items are generated out of thin air. More gold available in the economy can lead to a higher inflation. And because botting can be scaled to hundreds, thousands or even more, this can really destroy the economy. This is the main reason why botting is so bad for a game. Another issue is that when regular players encounter botters, it has a negative emotional effect on them. They feel cheated, maybe even their kills get snatched away, they can't buy stuff anymore because of inflation, and they can't find real players to chat and go on adventures together. So if we design a game to defend against this threat, what can we do? Should we invest into obfuscating the client, making the network protocol super complex, implement or buy scanning solutions that behave like antivirus software trying to identify bots or hacking tools through heuristics? But these are all terrible solutions because they are expensive and ineffective. A dedicated botter can always bypass those locally running scanning tools. It just slows them down and maybe prevents simple people from doing it, but professionals that earn their money with botting, they will find ways around it. Much more elegant solutions are solving this through game design. For example, Guild Wars 2 doesn't have a concept of kill, experience, loot or resource stealing. Everything is shared, so players won't have bad experience with bots stealing their kills. You can also design your game and server logic in a way that you completely don't trust the client. For example, let's say you have a dungeon and at the end is a reward. Instead of spawning the reward chest at the start and having closed doors preventing access, you can have a mission timer or different checks before the server spawns it at the end. Thus, if somebody has a client-side wall hack or even control over the communication protocol, they can't just access the chest right away. You can also implement more complicated boss fight mechanics that require dodging and positioning so that bots have to be really smart in order to farm it. You can also make a lot of resources account bound so that a lot of the good loot can't even be traded or sold by the bot owners. You can also have instanced MMOs because then bots can do everything without ever being seen from players. Thus, it helps against a bad perception of the game. It's kind of fun trying to think of systems that make bots less effective to protect the game, isn't it? But what about trading bots? Because this is a little bit different. I claimed earlier that the in-game economy, mainly the inflation, is a crucial part to keep a game healthy. So how does a Guild Wars 2 trading bot affect the game? First, I have to explain how the trading post works. When you have an item, you can list it for a price. Listing an item costs 5% of the price you choose, that is paid right away. Then if somebody buys the item, another 10% of the gold is taken away. Basically, you have a 15% sales tax on each trade. And placing a buy order does not cost anything. So this means that a trading bot, instead of printing in-game money, it actually removes gold from the economy, 15% at a time. So a trading bot is in a weird way actually helping to fight inflation. Also, I would claim that the casual regular player likes to buy items when they need it from the trading post and sell items right away to somebody who offered to buy it. That's not the most efficient way, but the most comfortable way. And so a bot who is constantly trying to overbid on items so they get buy orders filled raise the price a casual player can sell an item for right away, and at the same time try to undercut when listing the item so the sell listing is sold quicker, which pushes the price down for casual players that just want to buy an item. So it even has another positive effect. However, there are also two major negative points. A trading bot is competing with all other players who would like to maximize their profits or engage in trading too. The undercutting and overbidding minimizes the profit a regular player can have. It also lowers the bot's own profit, but a bot can obviously do a lot more trades than a human and can thus justify a lower profit margin. And another issue is that if a player feels like there are bots trading, it can have a very negative emotional effect, a feeling of unfairness and so forth. Even though maybe objectively a trading bot is not bad, regular players will not see it that way. So I believe a trading bot is unfair, though it's not bad or dangerous for the game, as long as players don't see them. So let's have a look at the data I've collected. I'm using a Jupyter notebook to work with the data and use it to create all the graphs. The code is terrible, please ignore it. I've not included the API keys, so you can't find which players were doing this, but you can find all the graphs in the description below and so you can have a look for yourself. First of all, over the roughly 3 months of collecting data, I have seen 94 unique Guild Wars 2 API keys. So I guess almost 100 people have downloaded the bot, executed it and entered the API key. However, when you look at the graphs, you will see that many have not actively used the bot. At the bottom, you can see the time span of the data collection. It started on the 12th of November and it went up to the 7th of February. My crawler checked the API every hour, so each point represents a bot being registered online and having some sell or buy data. You might wonder why there are only 76 bots and not 94. That's because 18 people basically didn't do anything. These 76, however, started the bot for a brief period, but even though they used it, there are still several that were basically never really active. So for example, user 72 downloaded and ran the bot for a couple of hours on the 23rd of November. After that, never again. In contrast to that, user 25 has basically a bot running 24/7 for the whole period. By the way, this gap over here was my fault. My crawler died and I didn't realize it quickly enough. And then there's user 55 who used it fairly actively but then stopped in December. Maybe went home for Christmas without their PC and then restarted the bot again when they returned in January. These graphs tell a lot of interesting stories. Now let's have a look at individual bot graphs. I think number 25 is awesome. It's a really active bot and I think it's the most active one that I've recorded. So you can see here dots with several colors. Orange is the gold they have in their wallet or inventory. Blue is the gold trapped in items they've listed for sale. So blue is a theoretic gold value they would get if they would sell the items. But now that I think about it, I think I forgot to deduct the 10% trading post tax from that. Anyway, blue should be a little bit lower overall. Red are the buy orders they have, so that's money that is waiting in the trading post for somebody who sells the item for this price. And black is the net worth. Basically, it's just the sum of gold value of the items listed for sale and the buy orders. It's the theoretic gold wealth of this account at the moment in time. So if we look at the start of this graph, We can see that the bot has constantly 400 to 1300 with up to 1700 gold in buy orders. And blue are the items being sold, so these items wait for a buyer. And you can see their prices always going up and down, meaning that new items are being listed for sale and that people buy items. Now, I think that there's always a dip down on weekends, which could mean that because on the weekend more players are playing, more items are being bought from this player. So money in listed items goes down. But I can't really explain myself those big jumps. So black is overall net worth, and I think there are clear upwards trends visible here with around maybe 750 to almost 1000 gold per week. But remember, a lot of the wealth is kept in items that might never get sold, so it's not all just raw gold. But here with those big jumps, I think maybe the calculation fails a bit and actually the user cancelled all buy orders and so forth and then moved gold away. Also, there's a fairly sudden drop in value of listed items, so maybe the person even cancelled a lot of listed items and relisted them lower or just outright sold them to the highest bidder, maybe? Well, I don't know, speculation here. This trend here I think is awesome. The listed items are slowly being sold off, which increases the available gold. However, the gold is immediately put back into ordering new items, so more and more gold is now in the ordered items. Overall, because by selling those items and ordering new ones, the bot made a profit and thus the overall net worth is slowly increasing. But the trading strategy during this time is also ineffective because ideally the listings wouldn't go down. They should be at least stable or rising with the wealth. But like I said, that's a very active bot and probably the most successful one. We can also use GW2 efficiency with the API key to spy a little bit what this player traded. So here they are. These are the secret items that apparently are very profitable to trade. The most money was apparently made with the black polyluminescence trinket. The Wargod skins are also good. By the way, if you are wondering why the listings are flatlining starting around the 9th of January, this can be seen also on the other graphs. Unfortunately, this is an issue with the Guild Wars 2 API. The listings are not updated, so the data there is faulty. Another very active bot, number 3, seems to be less successful. Here the net worth is pretty constant, so it's kinda useless to let the bot run. But 30 looks awesome, but don't get fooled by the slope and look at the y-axis steps. Here the bot started with around 200 gold and made maybe 500 gold in about 3 weeks. That's also not very great, and those drops look really like the person pulled out winnings into another account. Unfortunately, this user's API key is invalid. Maybe they got banned, or maybe they just removed the API key because they stopped using the bot. So, is this bot worth it? I'd say clearly no. A lot of graphs are pretty much just a flat line, so the users don't choose good items to trade. And you have to include the electricity cost, hardware cost, and game key cost, plus subscription for the bot. I think it's a complete waste of money and better spent on buying game cards. Also, should the average Guild Wars 2 player be outraged over these unfair bots? No, absolutely not. Those are small fish, they don't really make a lot of gold, always risk getting banned, and it's just a handful of people. This is not a problem you should worry about. I don't think it has any negative effects on the game. And as long as you don't cause an unjustified player uprising, this is just fine. By the way, if somebody from ArenaNet wants the API keys to hand out some 7-day warning bans, send me an email.